Right, I've actually stood now on the lagoon swim, where this is probably where your rods would be. If you have a look round here, this is where your bivy would be. We'll have a walk around the rest of the lake and see what it is, but yeah, pretty high. We'll have a look at the new top, the new stop pond now. It's pretty high, but out. Could do with emptying out a bit, but the trouble is there's nowhere to pump any excess water to. As you'll see when we go around the lake, everywhere's pretty flooded. We'll carry on up.
Right, we'll have a look in the winter disabled. The peg where everyone thinks they built the swim to one.
Nice gravel, do it. Boat point.
She's going out, she's coming. Peg 7-6 on the Egland. That Christmas tree thing there, planted that, must be, but it's 10 years ago when we planted that.
Yeah.
And then three there. We planted loads all around and the bloody rabbits came and hit them, but they're not exactly quick growers, are they? We should have decorated it perhaps, put some baubles on it. Oh yeah, that's peg 6 there. Peg 5 on the summer beer. This is peg 70, the bottom corner before the trout bank on the Summer Bay Road bank area. Don't know if you can make it out through there, we'll go and have a look, but the water running in over there.
Thousands of pounds being showed up, so God knows what it's going to be like.
It's coming into 69 now. Nice little waterfall. Yeah. Miles is going to get his canoe out in a bit.
So yeah, this is looking down from 69. You wouldn't believe, well you would believe, we've had a couple of people phoning up this morning saying it's unfair that they can't go fishing. I mean, what, the fucking mind boggles with some people, it really does. I don't know. It's going to get worse before it gets better. It's all pouring into the lake. There's nowhere for it to go. There's nothing we can do to stop it. Please write in with your suggestions how we stop this. See, troutfish are next. Oh, look at that. You can't even tell where the stream is. Yeah, this is a road. Just coming up to the spring swim now. God knows what it's going to look like tomorrow when all this is gone. Look at the spring swim. Yep, so unfair that people can't come fishing. It's all our fault.
for a noise, mate, people. It's unfair. I've paid my permit money. I need to go fishing, mate. What the fuck do you expect us to do? A bloody thing for that sun, no? Right, his voice is not bivvied up here. It's nearly up to waist height. Well, there's no fish in here. This is crazy, isn't it? My words. Heading up to the top end of the lake now, up back towards the sluice and the top slop pond. I don't know if you can see the behind through there, that's where the field used to be. It's now a big lake. Stream they built last year. 47. Yeah. Try and move a bit of that stuff. Watch yourself at the deep down there. Alright, let's have a look, clearing a bit of this up. Right, brace yourselves. This is going into the top stop.
I think you might have to turn the electric off in the thingy for that, because I think that's going up to the electric box.
Yeah.
little fence back there then. You see it?
The art fence?
Yeah, it's got that much.
Yeah. Fuck's sake. Man,
definitely
that's
bad.
Definitely
have to fly over that now.
Just check
me
out. Got the electrics in that up there. Turned it off like, but the water's nearly up to the top of the got 400 or 500 fish that we've been growing on for 3 years in here, so. Okay, now. Jesus.
Yeah, that's
going to
be quite a
good time
to
see
them.
It's a mess. Yes, I'm sure we had to worry about what if you can go fishing or not. Not far off that electric plug socket there. Man alive. It's saving grace, this is this off the fence here, if the fish can't go too far. Jeez, it's all the way down there as well, isn't it, man?
Huh?
All the way down there.
You're actually going out the lake down there.
So yes, this is why the lake's closed and you can't go fishing. So, I hope you all had a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.